Well, hello, Bishop Patrick L. Wooden Sr. here. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 9 and verse 6, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. The government shall be upon his shoulders. His name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end, upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom to order it and to establish it with justice." King James says judgment, "and with justice." That is, with justice and righteousness from henceforth and even forever, the zeal of the Lord of hosts shall perform this. Luke's Gospel, chapter 2, the Bible says this in verse 11, "For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord." Listen, my friends, Merry Christmas. Yes, we're in that time of the year again. We're have entered into the Christmas season. We've just celebrated Thanksgiving, and here we are now looking to celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Let me say this to you. I know that this Christmas season for many, 2020, this year has been a very different and difficult year, to say the least. Many who are watching are missing loved ones who have passed away due to COVID-19, this pandemic, and other conditions. Many of you have been rattled by the unrest that we've seen in the streets, the protests, the brutality, all of the things that have taken place, lives that have been lost. We're in a 24-hour media that is dedicated to making sure that the news is negative and that you stay in a state of depression, or that they keep you in a state of depression, if at all possible. I realize, my friends, that this has been a challenging year. And many of you may be under the impression that you have nothing to rejoice over, nothing to be excited about, no reason to be merry. But my friends, I want you to know, yes, you do. The prophet Isaiah said, "In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord." And he said that the God of the Bible was high and lifted up, and that his train filled the temple. He saw the seraphims flying around saying, "Holy, holy, holy, Lord God Almighty." And then they said something that I want you to get today. They said that the whole earth is filled with his glory. It was true then. It's true now. Just take the time to look around. Just stop and listen. Inhale and exhale. Look and you will see that the glory of God is everywhere. The earth is filled with his glory. I want to encourage you. I know that we come every week about this time to invite you to join us for church service, and I want you to join me tonight. But the Lord put you on my heart, and the Lord instructed me to say to those who are struggling, not only struggling from losing a loved one, dealing with the pandemic, dealing with shutdowns. Many of you, your businesses are struggling because you're unable to open up, and many of you have been laid off of your jobs, and the PPP payment is gone, and you're wondering, "Oh God, how am I going to make it?" The Lord told me to tell you to rely on the very thing that we talked about the very first of the year. God spoke to me for the year 2020, and the Lord said, "Declare and proclaim God's truth." I never said that 2020 was the year of God's truth, because every year, every day, every moment, every hour is the year and the time and the moment and the day of God's truth, but that God's truth would be challenged in 2020, and that we are to proclaim it and stand on it and trust it no matter what. And my friends, It is God's truth that has brought us to where we are today. It is God's truth that you are living and breathing and able to hear this message today. It is God's truth that will encourage you to get up and get dressed and come on out to the service, or for those who can't join us live in the sanctuary, to be a part of the word of the Lord and the Bible study that will take place here tonight in the sanctuary at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ. And yes, my friends, it is God's truth that will get you through the season that you're going through, the things that you are encountering, the loss that you have suffered, that sense of instability, that sense of uneasiness that's in the air. Let me tell you something. I want to say something to you to encourage you today. God's got you. God has me. We're in his hands. I'm reminded as I bring this to a close today, of the song, the great song that is written, It Is Well. The writer says, when peace like a river attendeth my way. That's one situation. Then he says, and when sorrows like sea billows roll. That's another. He described extremes, extreme good and extreme bad. He said, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul. My friends, I want you to say to the God of the Bible today, no matter how high you may be or how low you may be, tell the God of the Bible, Lord, I trust that you know what you're doing. I know that you are in charge. I know, oh God, that you love me. And I know, Lord, even though I may not understand everything that is happening in my life right now, and the things that I'm contending with, the sickness in my body, the uneasiness that I feel, the lightness of my pocketbook, the insecurity on my job, the unrest that is in the street, the political situation and the 24-hour news coverage of this, that, and the other, and it all seems to be slanted in a negative direction. God, I may not understand this. And then on the other extreme, there are people, everything is going your way and the Lord is blessing you. Regardless of where you are, I want you to say to the God of the Bible, Lord, I trust you. I believe you. So therefore, Lord, it is well. It is well with my soul. I thank you, Lord, for giving us the privilege to believe you and to trust you. When we believe on you, we make our request. We ask you for what we want. That's believing God. God, I've asked you to heal. I've asked you to deliver. Well, God, I'm believing you. And as I believe, I wait for God's response. I wait to see what the Lord will do. Whatever God does, whether he answers my requests and do what I've asked, or even if God decides to go in a total different direction altogether, that's when my trust comes in. And I say, Lord, I trust your response. And therefore, my response to you will be that I'm going to praise you. I'm going to worship you. I'm going to believe you, and I'm going to follow you. Even though I may or may not understand, I may or may not even agree with what you're doing. I wanted a different answer, but you answered the way you answered. And here's what I know about you, O God of the Bible. You do all things well. What a mighty God we serve. He said, pray that my will be done. My friends, I want to tell you, you're in the will of God. Stay there. Serve the Lord Jesus Christ. And let's make the devil out of a lie. Regardless to what the conditions may be between now and Christmas, whether there's another stay-at-home order, a shutdown, or whatever the case may be, I don't know. Only God knows. Whatever happens, here's what we can do. Here's what we can control. We can control our heart. we can control our minds and we can control our decisions. I have purposed in my heart that I'm going to follow Jesus and I'm going to trust the Lord and know that he loves me and that he loves you. And we're going to make this a Merry Christmas. We're going to acknowledge him. We're going to make sure we'll never surrender this season to the secularists. We will never surrender it to the materialists and the materialism that accompanies this great observation, the observation of the incarnation of Christ. God came to the world. Can you believe that? Just think about it. God came to the world in the form of a baby. And ladies, he came and he grew and he developed in the womb of the Virgin Mary. And that beautiful woman gave birth to the King of Kings and to the Lord of Lords, to the Son of David, to the seed of Abraham, to the stone hewed out the mountain, to the meek and humble lamb, the one who died a vicarious death. He took my place. It should have been me on that cross. It should have been you on that cross. Instead, he went. So let's love him. Let's serve him. I can't wait to study the word of the Lord tonight. Oh, we've been making progress. And the word of the Lord, the book of Daniel, chapter number 11, is showing us, if it's not showing us anything else, it is showing us, it is showing the world, those who are following this ministry, that the God of the Bible is indeed in charge. And it's going to be like he said, the word of the Lord cannot be stopped. It will come to pass. So join me here tonight at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ for Bible study. You guessed it, Bible study. Tonight, right here, we're going to study the word of the Lord together. If you can't get here, then join us on Facebook Live and YouTube Live. And we thank you for those of you who join us on these mediums. Thank you for your prayers. Thank you for your support. Thank you for the kind comments. And thank you for being Bereans. Go back and study the scriptures. After we've laid the scriptures out there, go back and study them to see whether or not they are soul, to see whether or not we're telling you the truth. God bless you. I love you. Be comforted by the knowledge that the God of the Bible loves you and you're in his hands. We'll see you tonight for Bible study right here at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ. God bless.